Well, as we mentioned a little earlier, Neil Mitchell, 3AW broadcaster, is going to be joining us live. He does so via the phone. Neil, did you see this coming?
Well, yeah, not today. I didn't see it today. But I've been thinking for some months that he was on his last legs. I think the body language was there. He was making political mistakes he wouldn't normally make. He's normally a superb political operator. He was getting a bit snarly in press conferences with minimum provocation. I thought the signs were there. He was running out of puff, and that's fair enough. We all do that.
Neil, it's well documented that you and the Premier, the outgoing Premier, don't see eye to eye. He slapped a long ban on your radio program. He was, however, generous enough to send you a text on the day that you resigned, or at least said that you'd be resigning at the end of the year. Will you be doing likewise, and what would you say?
Yeah, I'll send him a text. I'll say all the best for the future. Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Is that what he said to you?
No, he was more generous than that, and I will be more generous. But, look, I hope his departure changes Victoria, because we need to change. This state is bitter, it's divided, it's cynical. We've got a massive debt. We've got questions around integrity. There is no accountability or transparency. I think there could be a rabble that takes over, but I hope not. I hope it's somebody who returns some integrity to government.
Neil, do you think Jacinta Allen's the person for the top job?
I think, look, she's probably the best choice. I don't see there's anybody else there. There's a kiss of death for you. That'll really help her in the caucus. But I think whoever takes over faces this massive problem. When a dictatorial leader like this goes, it leaves a power vacuum. Now, Daniel Andrews has been running this place, running the whole government, as a one-man operation. You come through my office, you deal with me, I make the decision, you do what you're told. When that powerful person goes, the next person comes in with a different style, and the Indians sort of run around the chief not knowing quite what to do. I think we could have a really unsettled time. That's the danger. And whoever takes it over faces a big problem. Getting them under control, they'll be running around like headless chooks. Suddenly the boss is gone. Oh, we can run wild.
We saw during the pandemic when Daniel Andrews broke his back, James Molino stepped into the role, and people said even though James Molino and Daniel Andrews are very close friends, he was a breath of fresh air because he had a different way of handling it. Would not someone like Jacinta Allen be able to breathe new life into the government?
I think that's the hope, and I think she might do that publicly. What I'm talking about is behind the scenes. Daniel Andrews has been running it in such a way you just sat there and did what you were told if you're a minister. Now, if that control goes, do they run wild? Do they make mistakes? Are they stupid things? Does Jacinta try to run it with the same iron fist? I'll be surprised. I don't think it's her style. But she's got a real challenge in front of her to get the troops under control and then convince the public that it's a new style of government. Suddenly, integrity and accountability back to government might be a good thing.
Not many leaders, Neil, and you've been around for a long, long time and seen so many prime ministers come and go, premiers come and go. I would imagine that your relationship with Victorian premiers goes back to, Dick Hamer? Would it go back that far?
Oh, yeah, I used to go to Henry Baldy's press conferences. Yeah. But, yeah, I knew Dick Hamer and I knew John Cain very well.
OK, not many go of their own accord, do they? Steve Brax comes to mind, and now Daniel Andrews. But is he jumping a sinking ship to a certain degree?
Well, it's funny. I was talking to a very well-known Melburnian about half an hour ago, and this shows the mood we've got in the state, who very cynically said, what is about to hit the fan? Is there something really ugly about to come up, and therefore Daniel's jumping before it does? I don't know that that's true. I don't think the ship is sinking, but it's certainly very unstable. In a way, maybe he's giving Jacinta Allen and the rest a chance to stabilise the ship and steam on. But they got a hell of a job.
There'd been calls about this for months now, Neil. Do you think it was really the Commonwealth Games decision to pull that sort of turned things around for Daniel Andrews as leader?
I think that was a big part of it. I said on air the day it happened, this is going to be the most damaging thing that has happened to Daniel Andrews this year. I think there was just no way of justifying that. It was a mess he created himself. It was a mess he spent a lot of money getting out of. And there was no way he could spin his way out of that. It was his fault. It was his error. It was his mistake. and we had to pay the bill. I think that did enormous damage to it.
Neil, I was just speaking with Dougal there before about the state opposition, and this is a classic opportunity for John Pesutto or whoever to actually galvanise the state opposition and say, OK, we've got a real run at this now, right? Suddenly the Labor Party, after 9 years, is vulnerable. What does the state opposition need to do now, and is John Pesutto still the man?
Well, I know what they're doing at the moment because they had a shadow cabinet lunch going on, and I was talking to somebody there a while ago, and they're partying. They've broken out the champagne. They reckon this is their big chance. I'm quite serious. They're at this lunch all telling themselves what a big chance they've got. I remain to be convinced John Pesutto is the man. It depends on the style of government we get, and he's going to need to be sort of standing up against that. And it's going to need strength. As yet, we haven't seen enough of that from John Pesutto.
All right, Neil, I can imagine that your phone's running hot. And as you say, you are in contact with the movers and shakers of this city, gauging their reaction. So we can check in with you a little later on, if you don't mind.
Of course, I'll be around.
All right, thank you. Neil Mitchell from 3RW joining us there, and we will check in with Neil later on. And interestingly enough there, when he was sort of saying that one of his contacts, confidants, if you like, has suggested, is there something coming? And I must admit, I thought the same thing when it came out saying Daniel Andrews is holding a snap media conference in 15 minutes, and I thought, oh, is there something coming?
Yeah, well, there's a mountain of work to do. It could be debt, it could be a whole number of issues that he could be dealing with at the moment. I'm not sure of anything in particular or if a report's coming down or what have you. But we do have some more reaction, I think...
From the Prime Minister.
From the Prime Minister.
His contribution as Daniel Andrews will continue post him leaving the position of Premier. And I'm sure that Daniel Andrews will continue to make a contribution in whatever field he sees fit in the future. I spoke to Daniel this morning and he informed me of the decision that he has made. It has been a real privilege for me to work alongside the Premier of Victoria, someone I shared a flat with here in Queanbeyan many years ago in my first term when I was first elected to Parliament back in 1996 when Daniel worked as a staff member here in the National Parliament House. Daniel's career has been quite extraordinary. He has had a lot thrown at him over the years. He stood up for his values at all times. And I wish him and Kath and the family all the very best. I can confirm that he did cook that barbecue that day in his backyard, in spite of an example of the sort of crazy stuff sometimes that's thrown at people in public life. Daniel Andrews has, throughout it all, continued to front up, continued to represent the interests of Victorians. He is a very passionate Victorian and he has served his state.
Anthony Albanese there is not just a Labor colleague, but also a former flatmate there, as he said in his early days there in Queanbeyan. You are watching Nine's extended coverage of the Daniel Andrews announcement that he'll be stepping down as Premier.